Decibel Geek TV presents the Kuhn Brothers Rockcast. And here's your host, Pete and Jim, the Kuhn Brothers.
This is episode 16 of the Kuhn Brothers Rockcast. We've been rocking for the last half hour, 45 minutes, so we are so ready, more than you are. Put your seatbelt on.
Yeah, well, I like how we started that, man. Yeah.
Right on.
Yeah. All right.
So,
put your seatbelt on and then take it off.
And then take it off again.
Drive 100 miles an hour down the highway.
And then put it on again.
And then put it on again while you're driving.
And take it off.
Crazy. Because we're going to go crazy tonight on our 16th Rockcast on Decibel Geek TV.
All right. And we're not just going to say, we'll be back in a minute. We're going to go straight to the fucking lightning round tonight.
Really?
Yeah. Lightning round. I'm going to name a venue. You're going to name your favorite band you've ever seen at that venue. And then you're going to name a venue, and vice versa.
And then we'll tell everybody what we have in store the rest of the show?
Yeah, real quick.
All right.
Like a couple venues.
You're surprising me.
You ready?
You're like stunning me with this new exuberance.
I have energy.
You have some serious energy. I hope you people have some energy.
I have penergy.
He's going to exhaust you by the time we get to the bedtime.
By the time we know, half hour from now, I'm sleeping, and he's going to be doing the rest of the show.
Yeah, you'll be driving home. Great. That's great. Sleeping and driving.
Uber. So we used to live in Phoenix, and we used to go to this killer little place called the Roxy. Great venue.
Yeah.
I got stopped by a cop there on the way home once in my brand new MR2, and he goes, and he let me go. He goes, "Have a nice car, just be real careful." And I was like a young punk, coolest cop ever.
Wow.
What was the best show you've ever seen at the Roxy? Because we saw a ton of bands at the Roxy.
I can't limit it down to one. That's going to be really hard. There's two that immediately come to mind, and one was the Shaka Messiah show
at the Roxy.
And they were the opening act for, right? Weren't they the opening act?
For who else? I don't know. I mean, I can just...
Or was it? No, it was T-Ride. T-Ride was the opening act. T-Ride was the opening act. Great band, and they're going to be in my...
But Shaka was better, right?
But Shaka Messiah blew us away that night.
I have two.
Sass.
I have Sass Jordan and a Blackthorn.
Wow, Blackthorn featuring Graham Bonnet.
Graham Bonnet from UFO and Bruce Kulick.
And Bruce Kulick. Oh, wow.
Or was it Bob? No, it was Bruce, I think. It's one of the Kulick brothers.
Yeah.
But look at Blackthorn. Fucking great. And, it's Graham Bonnet. Okay, so that was a place called the Roxy, and right off of downtown Phoenix.
Yeah, downtown Phoenix.
Really great place. It might still be there for all I know. Okay, what's a good venue that we've both been to?
Okay, let's go with a big arena one. Let's go with Hollywood Sportatorium.
Now, you're going to say that, and I have it. I'm ready.
Are you ready?
I actually went by myself.
It's no longer there, guys. It's like the racetrack now. It's what used to be.
And we used to call it the Hollywood
Snortatorium.
For obvious reasons.
You know it.
And then
Rock and Rondos, if you watched his last podcast.
He'll know why we call it the Hollywood Snortatorium.
He knows why we call it the Hollywood Snortatorium instead of the Sportatorium. You have to watch that episode of the Rock and Metal podcast.
I walked out on shows at that place, and I went by myself to shows on that place. And the one I went to by myself... And forgive me, Kiss fans.
Okay.
I went to see Ted Nugent open for Kiss.
Okay.
And the only reason I went was to see Ted.
I bought a shirt. I remember you had that shirt for years.
It was the greatest shirt ever. And it was like Ted Electric with freaking lightning and shit. But that was the greatest show at the Hollywood Sports Tournament. I think I stayed for Kiss. I stayed for the whole thing. The only show I ever left there early was Bon Jovi. It was so fucking bad. Slippery when wet, I left.
Right.
But I'm all talking really fast. But yeah, it's Ted Nugent.
So you want... All right. All right. And we'll do this again next week. We'll like start off the show or do some segment of the show about venues.
I'm supposed to give you a venue.
No, we're going to stop. Okay. Because I have a story about the Hollywood Sportatorium.
Okay. And then... Okay.
Okay, so I saw Def Leppard there on the Pyromania tour. I saw them, a couple times, but that was when they played... They started huge, and they played the Snortatorium, and I saw them on the Pyromania tour, and so...
Middle of the Everglades, by the way.
Oh,
my
gosh.
It's so hard to get to in the middle of the Everglades.
Yeah.
Now it's probably easy to get to with highways everywhere.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And of course, because the race
And there's prisons. There are prisons around there, too.
Oh, man. It was
Florida State prisons.
Rough area, and if you got lost, then you'd be eaten by alligators.
You'd be lost forever.
Yeah. And so I'm at Def Leppard show, and I have to go to the bathroom so bad. And there's no place to go to the bathroom. And then I go all the way up to the top to see if there's a bathroom on the third floor, and people are like, no, you got to go up to roof access. Everybody's pissing on the roof.
Off the roof?
On the roof, like just pissing on the cement on the roof.
Is it slanted a little bit at least?
You know, no, it's just...
It's puddling.
It's puddling.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, and so, but here's the deal. I did it. Longest piss I've ever taken.
Best piss ever?
Yes.
Can I tell you the longest piss I've ever taken?
Best piss ever.
When I was in elementary school, and I was walking home from elementary school, and some lady on the way home came out of her house. This is back in the old days when people weren't scared like that. And she goes, the president just got shot. Ronald Reagan got shot. And I couldn't believe it. And we ran home, me and Benny, and I had to piss before I turned on the news. And it was the longest piss ever. And I'm like, I got to get to the fucking news.
Right, because they're going to not talk about it.
Right, well, not as sad, no, but I got to see what happened. And it ended up being like a minute 30.
Oh, no, this one was a 3 minute.
You had a 3 minute
piss. I think it was a 3 minute
piss. Wow, this show's going to be good.
So that's how we start off episode 16.
We'll be right back.
What are we going to do? I'll tell everything that's going on in the show so these people know exactly what's going on.
I have a great story of that one time when I threw up in Jimi Hendrix's mouth. Yeah, it was at a party, and then I left, and I was so scared I left. I don't know what happened after that. So what do you got going on?
Is this the liar show?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, all right.
No. I was 3 years old, and I threw up in his mouth.
While he was holding you like a baby.
I was so scared, though. After I did it, I was like, holy shit, he actually might die. So I crawled out of there as fast as...
I got some bad news for you. I'll talk about it in the break. Yeah.
Eric
talk
Gales? About the break. No?
No.
So what are you going to do with this show? What do you got?
I got nothing compared to that.
God damn, you were supposed to come up with a good lie.
I can't top that.
All right, we'll be back.
We have a perfect 10. We do have music news. We do have
a story to tell you.
An obvious funny bedtime story to tell you.
Maybe we'll sing, maybe we won't. Maybe we'll squeeze each other's nipples, maybe we won't.
Because that happens every fourth
and
show.
And I've got the block on just 16. In case.
Yeah.
All right, we'll be back.
We'll be back.
With some music and some videos and shit.
Yeah. Stuff that Rock and Ron does good, right?
Well,
producing us.
Well.
Yeah.
Good.
Does good and great.
My way to go, teach.
My students are watching. That's wonderful. Be back in a minute. Let me go to the show. I think the bad boys playing that rock and roll. Our sponsor is Wolfpack Productions.
They're our circle jerks.
We love Anthony and Jim and all the boys and girls.
And those mother crazies just announced another killer concert tonight.
Oh my gosh,
right
on show.
At the Buffalo Rose on March 8th.
Back to the Buffalo Rose, revamped, repainted,
restyled,
remodeled.
Ghosts roaming the hallways. I can't
wait. We can't wait to go see. Who is it, Jim?
Winger.
Winger.
My
Kip's
brother.
Coming to town. I can't wait.
My brother, Kip.
Yeah.
Kip, I'm tagging you.
We can't wait to see Kip.
Kip's coming back into town. He used to live here in Denver. He's coming back. His brother Nate will be there, I'm sure, and all of his buddies from Denver.
Yeah.
It's always a party when Kip comes back to Denver.
Name two other shows, and you're going to see graphics for all these other shows.
Yeah, so that's in March. And right after that show in March, like a week or two later, is the Red Dragon Cartel.
Yeah, Jakey Lee and Phil Verone, and we'll be there at that one for sure.
All right, but more importantly...
Oh, boy. Why? Because you wore the shirt?
No, because they're more of my favorite band.
Okay.
One of my top four favorite bands.
They are, aren't you?
In the world.
Aren't they?
Yes. They're coming here on January 19th. Steelheart. Mealy, that song, I won't say it, it's Mealy, and the guys, and it's going to be just phenomenal, and that's January 19th, so make your plans, if you get any extra money for Christmas or anything, put
come
it towards this show
on
Wolfpack, get a VIP pass for Wolfpack, and meet Mealy, and get your picture taken with the band. These guys are phenomenal, they're actually legendary, if I may say.
And then there's a whole bunch of other great Wolfpack shows, including Dokken, blah, blah,
yep.
Blah, Kicks. And,
so,
well, you just watch this.
Check out this graphic.
Yeah.
Check out this graphic and listen to the school background music.
Do it. Let's go to the show, buddy. I'm running with the pack. to the Kuhn Brothers, a Rockcast on Decibel Geek TV.
Mr. Gaga.
Yeah. I'm not Lady Gaga.
No, he's Mr. Gaga. Mr. Gaga. You've been waiting for them.
I'm actually Mr. Goo Goo.
Yeah?
That's what I spit a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
Jim's going to start
a lot of Goo Goo.
Jim's going to start off the perfect 10 tonight.
Yeah, I sure am. You know what? This album...
Why haven't we chose this one yet?
I don't know, but
we're idiots.
I found it in my collection, and I'm thinking, God, one of my greatest CDs and one of my most hated CDs at the same time.
Ooh.
God.
Cryptic.
Yeah, and you know what? It's Gene and Our Appetite, right? We all love this, but it was on the other side of Nirvana.
Right.
Right? It was Nirvana and had their... Both the end, well, it was actually Appetite was the end of rock and roll forever. Of good, it really was. Appetite for Destruction was the last killer heavy metal album. And then Nirvana was on the other side of that.
And Alice in Chains and other great bands.
Yeah, and
but Nirvana wasn't a great band, I agree with
no,
you.
No, Alice is better than Nirvana.
Oh, all my that God, goes. It's ridiculous.
But this was the album on the right side of things. And then on the other side of things, bad shit happened.
Boy, things turned.
Things turned really bad. They turned bad. So Appetite for Destruction, it's a classic you should all have in your collection. I don't have to say anymore. Here's a killer song from it. That killer song.
You guys know I'm a Southern rock fan. I love Southern rock, and this brings
Southern
metal.
Rock. He loves Southern rock.
No, rocks.
He loves Southern rock.
Rock is Southern rock. This band brought that together for me. Brought all that metal and
rock and roll.
Played one of their songs as an intro to one of our earlier episodes. But I friggin' love Jesse James Dupree and Jackal. Man. From I Stand Alone, every single song.
The Rain.
When will the rain?
I love The Rain.
I remember listening.
I feel the heat from the road. I can't feel the pain.
And we said we'd sing tonight, so there you go.
That's how it goes.
That's how it goes. Again,
how badass are we? When we know the song, we sing great.
Back Off Brother, She Loves My Thing.
She loves my sock.
Did you say cock?
She loves my sock.
Yeah, we can say cock on the show because...
Rockle roll me, jackal me off, motherfucker.
Yeah, that was the shirt, right?
Yep.
Jackal rules.
They do rule. Jackal Wagner too, right? Can't get along with my boys from April Wine. And the bass player recently passed away. I still love them to death and they're still touring. Love April Wine. I like to rock. I mean, well.
She's a roller!
High rolling baby!
Yeah, yeah!
She is! So you got that going for you.
And you got our singing going for you.
Yep. So here's a killer song. I want to hear.
Well, good luck with this rock and roll.
Yeah!
Which one do you want to hear?
I want to hear.
Over Town?
No.
She walk.
No, right, no, right. No, you know what? I want to hear I Like to Rock, because that's what the fans would like to hear. I Like to Rock. It starts out slow, and then it's like, holy fuck, I remember this song. Here's I Like to Rock. We'll be right back.
Monsters of Rock cruise for the first time. A virgin band who's been around forever, who I absolutely love, and we have different opinions on Doug Pinnick, but this is King's X. And I, man, this is my favorite. Again, Gretchen, there's so many good King's X albums. And my best of, that my friend Ken made me, has all those songs on it. But this album is one of my favorites. I absolutely love this.
Is this a King's X album?
Next is the, yeah.
King's what number?
Faith, Hope, Love.
Well, first, second, third album?
Second.
What, like an early album?
Yeah, it's early.
Yeah, I don't watch it.
Is it Love? I mean, there's so many good songs off the CD. And their voices together.
Is that the best of the four?
By far the best of the four. Maybe one of the best solo
rock and run
from any band member, like, ever. I can't remember any band member who's gone off and done their own
yeah,
thing.
Yeah,
yeah, this is really, Rock's giving really? Us a, I don't know.
No, that was the second best, yeah.
Or, okay.
So what would be Paul Stanley's?
No, I don't know.
Who would be there? Yeah,
oh, really? You think it's better? Really? Wow, really?
Yeah, that's I agree.
Rip It Out.
Yeah. Well, Rip It Out's great.
Speaking Back to My Baby. I mean,
right, on. So, it's definitely a quality pick.
I love Ace. We'll have an Ace story coming up in music news.
And here's a killer song from Ace.
Yeah, whatever rock and roll decides.
New York Groove rocks. I feel so good tonight. Who cares about tomorrow? So baby, you better believe. Of Doyle Bramhall. This is called Smokestack.
Nice.
It's not Smokestack Lightning, right? It's just Smokestack. It's Smokestack from Doyle Bramhall to a Stevie Ray Vaughan prodigy, one of his best friends, his father.
Open your eyes. Your eyes are.
No, I'm concentrating.
Oh, okay.
He was Stevie Ray Vaughan's. His father was Stevie Ray Vaughan's best friend, and Doyle was in his Archangels, and I love him, and I've talked to you about him a million times. This is his first solo album called Smokestack. It's got Green Light Girl, which is fucking amazing. It went...
I love Kid Rock.
Oh.
I could have done this as a guilty pleasure, but it shouldn't be. Because the guitars, the drums...
I am surprised he
mentions... And our friend Kenny Olson plays on this, right? Devil Without a Cause is groundbreaking shit right there.
Hey baby, it's cold
I'm
outside.
Going platinum.
I don't know.
That's Devil Without a Cause, bitch.
Well, good.
I'm trying to be like, you know,
pro Kid Rock.
Well, not only that, but like trying to be hip for the people out there. Like, you know,
you're so white, it's ridiculous.
Very white.
Oh my god.
They're called I'm Mother Earth, and they're from
Canada.
Oh,
yeah.
And I know Rich and Wally have heard of I'm Mother Earth.
what's going on here?
I don't know.
You're fucked up.
Yeah, it's just
this played it so many times. Forever. What is this, 1980? What?
Rain Will Fall was probably the song you've heard. Not Quite Sonic is another song you've heard. Whichever one Ron decides to play from that is fine with me. We're going to try to go through music news as fast as we can without going off tangent.
And without slurring our words.
Ready? All right. So.
Go.
Music news.
We'll be right back.
Does that... You got to throw a little...
That's not a good start.
No?
No.
All
right. We'll be right back after he throws it.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Extra.
Music news. All right, I'm going to start. You ready? This news came out...
Wow, you just decided, I'm going to start. You didn't even talk to me about it.
Do you want to start?
No.
Okay. All right, this came out today. It might have happened yesterday, but... I was playing.
Don't play.
Cannibal Corpse, guitar player. Have you guys heard about this? Cannibal Corpse just announced that they're playing on a four-band tour, and they're so thrilled because they're playing with Slayer, Lamb of God, and... Amon Amarth.
Yeah.
I hope I said that right. Amon Amarth. So Cannibal Corpse, totally excited. So what do? The fucking guitar player goes and gets arrested. He lives in Tampa. So in this suburb of Tampa.
Everyone in Tampa gets arrested.
Northdale. Have you heard of Northdale, Tampa?
I don't know Northdale. Must be a newer community.
Yeah, I'm sure it's bad. Okay, so here's the deal. His house caught on fire. And then all of a sudden, while they're putting out the fire, hundreds of ammunition starts going off because it's burning up.
Wow.
Yeah. So a massive fire, deputies, blah, blah, blah. They got the an hour and a half. They struggled with everything. Okay. Here's the cool part. Not really. About the same time the house caught fire, the sheriff's office got a call of a burglary on the other side of town.
So they all left and he was cool?
Well, it happened to be the same house. The guy that got the burglar.
Yeah.
His house, he set his own house on fire. And then he went and burglared another house.
People are fucking stupid.
Yeah, so he's now arrested and he's in prison. $50,000 bond. He's the guitar player for Cannibal Corpse, so...
So if you want to play guitar for Cannibal Corpse...
Well, no, if you have tickets to these concerts with them coming up, I know there's another concert Cannibal Corpse is playing with other bands, not Slayer, but other bands. But obviously he's going to have some legal troubles and he's either going to be kicked out of the band or it's just a band you don't want to see because this guy's... You don't want to support shit like that. You don't. And his fucking picture of the cop, he's like, he's got meth fucking scabs all over his face. Fuck him. Okay, your turn.
Alright.
Cannibal Corpse can... He looks like a fucking corpse, alright? The guitar player looks like
and
a corpse.
He, and if he keeps up his axe, he probably will be one, right?
Their whole band will be in the corpse of Rock and Roll.
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and I know we have, like, you know, this problem with Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, as we all do, but Def Leppard was voted in number one.
Do you know what that means?
For the public opinion.
Do you know what that means?
Yeah, I know what it means, but hang on a second.
Okay.
Stevie Nicks was number two.
Doesn't mean anything.
The Zombies was number three.
Ooh.
This is rock acts, not just like pop. It's just the rock acts.
Well, first of all,
The Cure, number four.
It's rock and
roll. The top five vote getters get put into a ballot and get to vote. And you know how much the public counts?
Yeah, one for each vote.
Percent.
One for each person that wins.
It's like 0.013%.
Each top five member.
You guys,
one vote.
If you're voting at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame
means
online,
nothing.
It means nothing. You're up. Express. All right. Go.
All right. So on that note, I'm gonna, here's a segue. Is that what you call
a segue?
A segue. I was joking.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. I hope you were joking.
Yeah.
Holy
here's
shit.
Here's a segue to Ted Nugent, who should be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, who should not be on his shit list because of politics. Ted turns 70 years old. Happy birthday, Ted Nugent. He turns 70 years old on this coming Thursday.
Poo, poo, poo! Let me kill an animal for no reason. Oh, keep going.
He eats them. December 13th is Ted Nugent's 70th birthday. And God bless him. He looks like he's 60.
Let me shoot a Democrat for no reason.
Poo, poo, poo! I'm shush.
I'm just Ted Nugent.
And Ted Nugent as a septuagenarian. 70-year-old man. He joins Ozzy Osbourne, who just turned 70 years old last week.
He's past the 68 mark.
And Alice Cooper, who's now 70 years old. So we have Ted, Ozzy, and Alice. Regardless of what you think, they're all fucking amazing people.
And Keith Richards, who's 146.
That's right. And actually, today, Nikki Sixx turns
60.
Yeah?
I heard about that. Nikki 60.
Yeah, Nikki 60.
Nikki 60.
All right.
So, happy birthday, Nikki 6. You rule.
All right. So, do you have any more news?
Yeah, I have tons of more news. Real quick one, because I mentioned I had Kid Rock as one of my perfect 10. So, let's talk about Kid Rock real quick and how cool he is and what he just did for people in Nashville, Tennessee. Kid Rock decided to pay off over 350 layaways for people at Walmart in Nashville, Tennessee for Christmas. And anytime I hear something like that, it gives me chills, as you can probably see.
Why?
It makes me, that's fucking cool.
Somebody just did the same thing a couple of days ago.
I don't know. I just don't care. It's just cool. It's just anybody who does that for people less fortunate. Anybody who does something for somebody less fortunate than themselves makes me happy. And he lives in Detroit. Why was he in Nashville?
I don't know
why he did it, but I don't care. Kudos, Kid Rock. Fucking, hey man, that's fucking cool. That's a really cool thing to do for people over Christmas. And more people who are more fortunate than a lot should be doing that for people who are less fortunate. That's my whole thing.
That's his whole thing.
That's my whole thing. Let's talk about...
Oh wait, we got this too.
M3 Festival. You mentioned that last week. You were like one of the first people to talk about all the bands.
Yeah, rocking on M3.
And so LA Guns is going to be there.
Hell yeah, no.
Why?
It's not the real LA
Guns.
I think the M3 bookers got...
They got totally swindled on this deal. They had no idea.
They got ramrodded.
Ramrodded. Bam! This is the different LA. So this isn't Tracy and Phil and Ace.
So when I saw LA Guns on M3, I'm like, wow, maybe Junkyard will play.
Right.
Because they're on the same end.
The same management.
But it's not the right LA Guns.
It's the wrong LA Guns.
And we're going to tell you.
So here we go again, folks. It's Rat all over fucking game.
It is. It's the Bobby Blotzer version of LA Guns.
This is Steve Riley's version of LA Guns. And so, again, they're splitting. Here's the difference. Steve Riley
looks like fucking Frankenstein, and he scares the shit out of me.
Skeletor!
He looks like fucking Skeletor. Every time I've seen LA Guns, I said to Pete, who's this fucking drummer, Skeletor? And then all of a sudden...
And when I met him, he was a fucking asshole. Let me be real honest with me.
Well, clearly he is, because he's posing as LA Guns.
You know, other than Tracy, not that the other guys I've met have been really fun to hang out with and stuff like that, other than Tracy. He was just like heroin out the whole time.
That's fine. Well,
you Skeletor.
Here's your LA Guns news for you.
There's your whole music news for the night. And we'll be back.
So actually, none of them have been nice to me. Oh. So don't, yeah. I mean, they're a good band, but they're not nice. So that's one of those ones, like, if you get VIPs and shit, blow them off and go get a beer. All right, I got an editorial real quick.
Oh, a Jimatorial's coming up.
No, let's do that right now.
Bedtime story. No, well, let's do a gym. Let's take a quick break.
And do some shots.
Do some shots. Do a Jimatorial and do our bedtime story.
Okay, we'll be right back.
All right, we'll be right back.
I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not going to take this anymore.
Well, I've been irritated with this for a long time. And I'm going to bring it to your attention. You guys,
gonorrhea. It's gonorrhea. He's been irritated with it for a long time.
Scratching, itching, a lot of Ray Liotta shit going on here. Now, if you disagree with me, that's fine. You can post comments or you can just go to sleep angry.
What's going on January 19th, Jim?
Well, Steelheart is playing.
They are playing.
And all the cool kids will be going to that band. But Steelheart. Also playing somewhere else in Denver is this shithole band.
They're also called Steel something.
Yeah, it's Steel Panther.
Oh,
it's this fake heavy metal band, right?
Yeah, they are.
So here's what my editorial's about, all right? Steel Panther. For all of my friends and genre people that like Steel Panther, go to sleep, wake up again, and fucking check yourselves, all right? These guys are making fun of the music we love. And it drives me crazy. Their lyrics are childish. Their fucking actions on stage are sexually overdone. It's ridiculous. I mean, not only for the era that we live in now, but even from the 80s. It's overdone. They're horrible. Their lyrics are stupid. The guys have fake names. They have fake wigs. It's not the music we love.
His name isn't Satchel?
It's not Satchel.
Is that his real name?
No, it might as well.
I'm so pissed off.
Yeah, it should be a satchel of my balls or something like that. Right? I mean, the guy has he has a guitar pedal that he sells. It's called the Pussy Melter.
Right.
All right? And yeah, it's funny for about 5 minutes. But give me a fucking break.
5 minutes.
Yeah, it's this Chinese product that he put his name on and he's making a lot of money on. All right? This is not the heavy metal shit that we grew up knowing and loving. They're weak. They make fun of our music. They have childish fucking lyrics and sexual overtones, which usually I like, but in this case is disgusting. Worse than the Kicks lead singer, which bothers me.
He is actually
and he doesn't even mean to do it.
He's a joke of the Kicks.
Oh, that's what it is. They're a fucking joke. So if you guys...
I'm supposed to disagree with you, so hang on.
No, you did. You didn't. You disagree
with me. I disagree with Jim.
So,
no, I totally don't.
I don't want to go off too much and piss off too many of you idiots, but if I do, then you're not the people I want watching me anyway. Steel Panther's a bunch of fucking pussies, right?
I couldn't agree with more. It's a joke.
They make fun of the shit we grew up loving and fuck supporting them.
All right.
Bam.
So, here we go.
Bam.
Do people know who Steel Panther, how they started out? Do you know how they actually started out?
As a fake band.
TV commercial.
Oh, it was Danger Kitty.
Danger Kitty. I can't believe you fucking know that. Oh my God, I didn't think you would know that. It was a joke. And then they became a band. And then they started making fun of the music we love.
Do not support that shit.
So, January 19th, there are two Steels playing in Denver.
The real band.
Steelheart, the real band. The band that's brought you incredible music since I never...
And Pussy Kitty. The band that we don't
like. And Danger Kitty.
Oh, Danger
Kitty. A joke band called
Danger Kitty. Steel Panther.
Yeah. Who just makes fun of our music.
Don't support that shit. They're laughing at you. They're laughing at you while they're
throwing. And for every fucking money, every dollar they make off you, they're laughing. Okay? I totally agree with you. I couldn't agree with you more on your gymatorial.
It's my editorial.
I want to disagree.
Woo!
I spilled whiskey. I'm an asshole.
I'll lick it up.
Lick it up. I couldn't agree with my brother more on this point. I wish I could disagree with him, but Steel Panther is a joke.
All right.
So go see Wolfpack Productions' production of Steelheart instead. Because that's a real fucking band that plays real music with real lyrics.
And we'll be there. I'll buy you a shot of Jack and Girl.
Oh my gosh, he's never going to remember that, but he's going to buy you a shot.
We'll be right back.
Story time.
Don't you sit right back, and I may tell you a tale.
Hey, it's Pete and Jim, and we're back for our Decibel Geek TV bedtime story.
I'm so sleepy.
And the Kuhn Brothers, he's getting sleepy because it's a bedtime story.
Yeah.
I'm all choked up about this bedtime story.
You're sleeping a lot of time.
No, I'm not sleeping. Okay. I'm wide awake!
I'm sleeping. Oh, God, that made me crazy.
So, our bedtime story tonight comes from...
our last cruise.
Well, it's a pre-Monsters of Cruise story. It's not on the cruise. We've told a lot of cruise stories. But this is a story where we went to Miami, Fort Lauderdale area, before the cruise, and we decided to hang out the day before with our friend Benny. So Benny, shout out to you. We love you. Jimmy's best friend since
five years old.
Yes. Benny has a house in Key Largo, and he decided to take us out in Key West and do a little tour. And so
we went everywhere.
It was totally cool. We had a blast. And so we go on this Key West tour, and he's taken us on all the classic bars of the Key West. One of the bars, I don't remember it, Ron's?
Jack's.
Rockin'
Jack's.
What was the one on where I got bitten by the pelican?
Oh, I don't know, but you guys will probably know this. There's this bar where you can buy fish and feed pelicans.
Yeah, so buckets of fish, and then you can feed the pelican, you can feed the fish. You're supposed to feed the fish. You're not supposed to feed the pelican.
He's an idiot. Oh my God.
So, I have this bucket. And it's filled with fish, and
what it is? It does tarpon in the water, and tarpon are huge fish, and they're absolutely huge. So like you're 5 feet long, but they weren't biting the day we were there. So more involved was the pelicans on the dock.
I go to feed the tarpon,
yeah,
and I have the bucket up here, like you're supposed to, because if not, the pelicans are going to...
Yeah,
like,
they're not nice.
Right?
They're hungry.
They're angry pelicans. Hungry. They're hungry. And so I have the bucket up here, and I'm feeding the fish. Funny. And so I start feeding the fish, but they smell the fish on my hands.
And they eat his
and
hands.
So I change hands with the bucket.
And about three of them start biting him.
All of a sudden, I have a bloody fucking mess.
And what am I...
Before the monsters of Rockcross. And what my hand looks like meat. Like,
and what am I saying? Over like 3 feet
away. Raise the bucket!
Let go of the bucket!
Let go of the bucket! And all my friends and everybody... And there's people I don't even know that are yelling, Let go of the bucket! Alright, but I'm not letting go of the bucket, because
I was such he paid $5 for these fucking
things. It was three, I think. Yeah, it was way expensive. And so my hands just chewed up.
But they're the most gorgeous birds. I mean, they're so pretty.
Oh, they were sweet. I wasn't going to smack the bird.
No, they're so sweet.
Well, I was the idiot.
He's such an idiot. And he had like bloody fingers, bloody hands. I have pictures. It's the greatest thing.
We'll show you a picture in a minute. Rocker.
No, I don't know if I can find it.
I have one. Yeah, I have one.
Yeah.
And it's got scabs and shit, as you can see.
But all the locals were laughing at you.
Everybody's laughing at me. So the bartender goes, come on over here. And I'm like, yeah, give me a shot of whiskey and give me a beer. And he goes, you need a towel? And he wraps my hand, my totally bloody pecked hand from pelicans.
Pectoral.
In a beer towel. Ooh. It was totally a beer towel. It was
like so, it would be infected in about 3 days.
Oh my God. And I was so not worried about it. I couldn't give it a shit less at that
point. And then we went and bought me a captain hat.
You bought a hat. You bought the captain hat that we got signed. And we're going to, you should wear that next week.
No, I don't think I need to. I think that's just the end of our story.
No, I don't think it's the end of our story. So that's...
It's really the end
of our story. No, it's not the end of our story. The end of our story is when he pulled up with Benny in his convertible Lexus back up to the hotel.
This was an 8-hour day of just...
The day before the cruise.
In the world.
Day before the cruise, we pulled back up to the hotel, which is the Regency, where a lot of people stay before the Monsters of Rock.
We're in this convertible Audi.
There's like three
Audi.
Hotels that everybody says. Audi or Lexus or whatever.
Oh, yeah. We pull up, and
it's convertible. So we jump out. We get back to the hotel.
Dukes of Hazzard style.
Look, I'm thinking Batman and Robin style. Batman and you're Robin.
Total Dukes of Hazzard.
Was it Dukes of Hazzard?
For me, at least.
All right.
If you want to be Robin, you can be Robin.
Oh, I'm more Batman.
Bo Duke.
You jump out. You're like, and who's at the actual hotel?
Ron Keel.
So from Keel, obviously.
So Benny drives us up to the front of the lobby. I jump out. I go, hey, Ron. Ron's like, hey, brother.
Ron's like, and Benny has no idea that Ron would recognize us, know who we were because we met Ron before. And Benny is a huge Keel fan, right? Yep. Benny loves Ron Keel.
Of course.
And so he's like, oh my God.
You guys are
Ron Keel. You guys are rock stars. And we're like, no, we're your friend. You're Benny. We love you. Yeah.
And I don't actually remember much after that.
Yeah, no, we don't remember anything after that. Night. That's the end of the story. No, I don't remember anything after that either.
I hope you got home okay, man.
Benny, that was two years ago. I hope you got home okay.
All right.
So, that's our bedtime story for tonight. It was me getting bitten by pelicans, us hanging out and being greeted by Ron Keel like we were rock stars.
And me buying my famous captain's hat on the cruise.
And that
we got signed by everybody that I'll give away if you guys really want next week.
No, you gave it to me.
Oh, I gave it away to him.
You can't give away that shit. You just gave it to me.
Do you have it at your house?
Yeah, it's
my
house.
Okay, well, then I can't give it away anymore.
But I'll wear it next week on our show. For our Christmas show.
So next time you see our names come up on your Facebook page, click on us. It'll be our next week's show. Awesome.
Yep. Next week's show is going to feature some Christmas stuff.
Go buy your shit.
Because, you know, that's what it has. We'll have Christmas lights. You're going to wear Christmas lights around your balls.
I'm going to bear it. Yes.
Right? All right. You may not see them, but I guarantee you, back down here, he's going to have Christmas lights wrapped around his testicles.
Two of them.
Two Christmas lights or two balls?
Two big balls. Two Christmas lights.
Oh my gosh. We can't wait for Christmas. We love Christmas. We love you guys.
No, we don't love Christmas.
No, we don't. We love Christmas.
You do?
I know it's Christmas.
But you know what? Next week is our Christmas show, and I've got two incredible songs that I'm going to download myself and give you about 30 seconds of because I don't want to like give you freebies.
Alright, well, I have Christmas songs too.
Wow, so there's a killer teaser of some new Christmas songs that you've never heard of.
Well, I don't know if they've probably heard mine.
Well, mine are from heavy metal guys that you've never heard of before.
Wow, what a tease.
Yep, and some heavy metal guys that you may have heard about before.
Next week, show 17, Christmas episode. We can't wait to see you guys and celebrate the holidays. It's that time of year where we all get stressed out, beat the shit out of each other, and we can't wait for that to happen.
Sanish Mana. Merry Christmas. We'll see you in a week.
Yeah, we'll see you in a week. Thank you so much for episode 16. You guys rule. We had a really good time tonight.
Sleep good. Take your drugs that your doctor's prescribed.
Prescription only, right?
Take the drugs that your...
Drugs?
I can't even say... Take them.
Take them. Take them.
The ones that your doctor prescribed me. Take them. That's what I'm saying. All right. We'll see you next
Memories.
Week.
Memories. We'll see you next week. Rock on. Rock and Ron.
Drink,
behind the camera.
Drink this one
out. Our ass.
Drink it out.
We love you
Have
guys.
A glass of water. Drink it out.
Drink it out.
Yeah. Piss in your pants.
See you next week. Boom. Episode 7.
Bam. Boom.